I'm sorry, I have some bad news for you. Inevitably, you're going to run into errors, and you're gonna have to figure out how to deal with those errors. Every QA automation engineer does, and it's part of the job. I run into errors every single day, and it's just a matter of figuring out how to deal with those errors. Step one is to debug your code. Read the error messages in your IDE. IDE these days are pretty smart, and they give you fantastic error messages that you can look at and understand the error that is being shown to you. IDEs even give you a line number and a character number that will point you to the right place where your error occurs. Go to that location and see what the IDE is complaining about. Usually there's some kind of a squiggly line pointing you to the error. Try to fix it. If that doesn't work, you can try to restart by going back to before you created the error. Use keyboard shortcuts such as Control Z to go back and Control Y to redo. You can press Control Z to undo your code to a previous state that was working, and then slowly, line by line, add the code in again until you see the breaking point. If you don't see the breaking point, fantastic. But if you do, now you know which line of code caused that breaking point. If restarting doesn't work for you either, you can then try to compare the code that you have to the code that I've provided for you in the course. You can pull up the code in any IDE side by side and use a diff tool. If, for whatever reason, your IDE doesn't have a diff tool, or you're just not using an IDE, you can even use something like Notepad++ Compare plugin to show you the differences in my code and your code. For example, this is a sample diff in a Notepad++ that shows you the differences between two files. You can just as easily do this with any code files. If none of those work, step number two is to check my blog. I've been doing this for a number of years now, and I've received the same questions over and over. So what I've done is created a blog post that contains the common Selenium Webdriver errors. So if you go to that URL, you'll be able to find a bunch of common Selenium Webdriver errors and how to fix it. If you don't want to remember that URL, you can just as easily go to my website and search for the string Selenium errors. It's going to pull you up the blog post. Let me show you what I mean. So, this is the blog post that I'm talking about. It's called Common Selenium Webdriver Errors and How to Fix Them, located at this URL. You can come here and look for the specific error that's in question and then find the solution and how to fix it. If you don't want to type in that whole URL, you can just as easily come to ultimateqa.com, search for Selenium Errors, and the first article that you're going to get is the article that you want. And then you can peruse through it again and get your errors fixed here. I update this article all the time. As soon as I find common errors that everybody's facing, I'm putting them in here. If none of those solutions work, you can move on to step number three, which is finding solutions online. This is what makes you an amazing QA engineer. No, I'm just kidding. It's just part of the job, going online and finding solutions. I do it every single day. That's so standard. My favorite place to go is Google. All you have to do is go to Google, put in your error message and the programming language that you're looking for, and then it will get you back a bunch of solutions. Let me show you an example. If we go back to this blog post and I just come here and copy this error message here, go to Google, type that error message in, and put C sharp, I'm going to get back a bunch of results. I can go through these results, read what the people are saying, try to apply those solutions and see if it works. Most of the time, 99% out of 100, someone in the world has already had a similar problem as you. And therefore, you'll be able to find some solution. And I'll give you a hint. All of these errors that are located in here, most of the solutions I found myself online, and I just did a better job documenting them for you. Finally, if none of those steps work, you are allowed to ask good questions. And that's why I'm here to help, along with our amazing automation testing community. Now, the key is to ask good questions. Again, go to that same URL that I showed you before for common Selenium WebDriver errors and leave a comment there documenting your error. Make sure that you are positive. You don't need to be upset. Everybody has problems with their code. I have them every single day. And if you're positive and just state your error, everything is going to be much better than you getting upset. I've seen too many people and too many coworkers constantly getting upset over errors when there's no need. It's just part of our job. Furthermore, I've experienced hundreds, if not thousands, of questions from you guys. And so what you need to do is be concise and specific in your question. Don't give me the code to your entire solution. You need to make it easy for the person that's trying to help you to give you the answer. Therefore, give the specific part of the code that doesn't work and your problem. A screenshot or copying and pasting the code is helpful. Formatting the code in a really nice way is extremely helpful to the people that are trying to help you. If you make it easy for other people to help you, they will be more willing to help. But if we have to spend 20 or 30 minutes trying to understand what your code is doing, nobody is going to want to help you. So make it easy for us, and we will be glad to help. And finally, just say thanks to the person that's helped. So many times I've seen that people will get help, and then they don't come back to say thanks. Sometimes I know that the error was probably fixed, but because nobody came back to say thanks, I'm not sure if that's resolved their problem, and neither is anyone else. So again, just go to that page, come down here to the bottom, and just write the simple comment of the problem that you're facing. The way this looks, of course, may change, but that doesn't matter. Just come here, write the problem that you're having, and our community will do our best to answer it. And I'm sorry that this button is so green and ugly. I promise that I'll change it.